is 2.2, question number 1, in that second number question, that is 4s square minus 4s plus 1. You can see here now x terms are not there, that's why we will rewrite this term as p of s now. 4s square minus 4s plus 1. Again you are multiplying 1 and 4, it will be 1 into 4, that is 4 itself. 2 factors of 4 you have to do, that is 4s square minus 2s minus 2s plus 1. Taking out common from both of this, 2 and s is common, what will be left inside the bracket? 2s minus 1. Minus 1 is common from both of this. Here nothing is common means minus 1 is common. Do remember that here minus sign is there. That's why minus 1 you will have to take out common. Internal signs will change, that is 2s minus 1. Again 2s minus 1. 2s minus 1 is common. Here 2s minus 1 is left, so 2s minus 1. Again, this equation can be rewritten as 2s minus 1 equals to 0 and 2s minus 1 equals to 0. Therefore, 2s is equals to what I can write? 1. S is equals to 1 by 2. Here also, same ways, 2s is equals to 1 and s is equals to 1 by 2. So, I got my two zeros. One is alpha, one is beta. Previous sum we have done, in that same things we have done, relationship between the zeros and coefficient we have shown. Here also same thing we will do. Again we are adding, sum of zeros will take, sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta is equals to equation is minus b by a. So you have to check here, 1 by 2 plus again 1 by 2. Is equals to what you are getting over here, final 2 is taken as LCM, 1 plus 1 will be added, so it will be 2. You got 1 over here, alpha plus beta sum is 1. Now minus b by a also will verify. Minus b means what? Minus sign as it is, b means minus 4 by a is 4 itself, so this will change into minus minus plus, so 4 by 4. This is also 1. So you can tell that sum of the zeros is also written as alpha plus beta is equals to minus b by a equals to 1. Now we are calculating for the product of the zeros. Whenever you are calculating product of zero, always multiplication will come. So again alpha and beta we will multiply. Equation also we are having c by a. Again we will do multiplication, 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. So this will change into 1 by 4. C by a, c is 1 over here, a is 4. So here also you are getting same quantity, 1 by 4 is equals to 1 by 4. So finally what we came to the conclusion, that alpha into beta is equals to c by a equals to 1 by 4. Either if you are solving as it is by addition of both of this, then also it is okay, then also you are getting the same answer. If you are keeping in the form of an equation minus b by a and c by a, then also you are getting the same answer. Okay.